Yeah. Thursday, March 19, 2005, this beautiful Shih Tzu female, around 4 years old, comes in with the complaint of what, the swelling here, is it?
Yeah.
Maybe you hold. With the complaint of licking the private parts. Now, this part is definitely swollen due to licking, and there is any discharge?
Yellowish discharge over the side.
No, I mean from inside?
No.
The general discharge?
Don't see anything.
Okay, this is some itchiness here. How long already this been going on?
Only recently.
Okay, when was the last hit? Last hit was which day? It was in January, right? The bleeding?
I can't recall already. I cannot think of.
No. How about last, the one before?
The one before, I think, was last year.
Which month? Was it in June?
I think it's May.
So May plus 6 is November. So roughly it's about 6 monthly. So now, 12, 1, 2, 3. So more or less, the dog may have hit. And because now it's November, let's say May, was it May?
I think it's always May.
So May plus 6 is November, November plus 6 again, 6 months. It should be about May again, but not every dog has 6 monthly, so some could be 5 months, some could be 4 months, so it varies, but this dog is quite thin. Quite thin. So this is the main complaint. Now, appetite good or bad?
This few days, no appetite.
No appetite, yeah?
Not really so good.
Drinks a lot of water?
Yes.
Drinks a lot of water. Pass a lot of urine?
Yes.
So abdominal palpation, I can feel the uterus. Uterine horns are swollen, but not very much swollen. This because of the passing of the yellow discharge, right? This will be open parietal. Now in female dogs, that's why they advise the owner, best to sterilize them young, because what happens is many of them, when they're old or older, they start to develop infection of the womb. And one of the signs and symptoms is, of course, yellow discharge from the vagina, and the dog keeps on licking it. So this dog keeps on licking until, because she tries to clean herself, she's a very clean dog. So she licks until the whole vulva is swollen and inflamed and itchy. And so the reason is due to pyometra, open pyometra. So in this case, the solution actually is to spay the dog as soon as possible. So now we'll treat for vagina infection, and then after, let's say, 2 weeks, then we will do the spaying. Other than that, now the dog has no appetite, so we'll do a blood test to check whether there's any infection or not. Any vomiting?
No.
So polyuria and polydipsia. Polyuria and polydipsia in a dog, in a female dog that has vagina discharge about 1 month or so after the heat period. Because the owner doesn't know exactly when was the bleeding. When was the bleeding? She doesn't know. So normally it's 1 to 2 months after this. So this is a sign of pyometra. In this case, it's open pyometra because when you do palpation, there's no swollen uterus. And because of this, the dog stops eating 2 days, right?
More than 2 days.
But drinks a lot of water and pee a lot. So polydipsia and polyuria in a female dog that has hit about 2 months ago, according to this, is January. Now it's March. Was it January? She's not really sure. Yeah.
Do you still remember?
So the first diagnosis is pyometra, open pyometra. Second diagnosis is vaginitis. Infection of the vagina. And was there any mating? No mating, right? Normally dogs don't get mated, yes.
Okay.
So now I put the dogs on antibiotics and take a blood test, and after that she should spay the dog to prevent this problem coming back again. But many owners, they don't take the time to spay the dogs. In fact, this dog is already about 4 years old. I advise her to spay the dog at 7 months plus, and she didn't have time to do it. So in many cases, female dogs, when they're older, they have this infection of the worm called pyometra, which is quite common in the older dogs, older female dogs. So prevention is still the best, which is by spaying. But for many reasons, some owners feel that it's cruelty to dogs, so they don't want to spay it. So they rather tolerate the menses, the bleeding, every 2-6 months. But in such cases, as you can see here, it sometimes develop into infections, and so still in the end, you still have to do it, to spay the dog. Okay.